Human behavior has always been a mystery. Why do people do what they do? Why do they react one way when we expected something else? How do we learn to understand, connect with, enroll, engage, align with people most effectively? Hi, I'm Christine Comeford, founder of Smart Tribes Institute, and welcome to our Smart Tribes Crack the Behavior Code podcast. In each episode, you'll learn practical, easy-to-use tools to better understand and change human behavior. These tools will help your team outperform, out-engage, outsell the competition. In other words, to become a smart tribe. Oh, and you'll find these tools super helpful in your personal life too. Let's go. People get into the wrong roles for a number of reasons. You know, perhaps there was a reorganization and the company didn't want to lose them, so they were reallocated without consultation or training. Maybe they were promoted beyond their capability without a training plan. Maybe they were hired to do a project that's not relevant now and they've been redeployed to produce meaningful results elsewhere. Maybe they were in over their head and they thought that the role could work for them, but it wasn't really the right fit. And then there's, of course, our all-time favorite, the Untouchables. Do you have Untouchables, also known as sacred cows? These are people who were hired because they're related to or friends with the CEO or other powerful team members. And even though their performance is subpar, they still get promoted, or at least they're allowed to stay. And you and I both know it's for emotional reasons. Case study, let's look at Company X. Company X was a tech consulting firm with $37 million in annual revenue, approximately 270 employees, about two-thirds of whom were consultants. They were tracking at about $137,000 in revenue per employee. Ouch, right? The company was run by a married couple, we'll call them John and Sarah, who initially contacted us about perfecting their sales process. They felt that their salespeople could be performing much better, but what we found was a much bigger issue. The findings were grim. A fear-driven culture, 53% employee turnover each year. Company X did an exceptional job of technical training for new hires, only to see them leave for higher pay within a year. The two owners of the company had virtually opposite meta programs, and this was causing chaos. Sarah was active toward options and difference, and we'll include the meta programs infographic on the show page. She would proactively start an initiative, rally the troops to move toward the new goal, and then jump to the next option or project. John, who was reflective, away, procedural, and sameness, would want to analyze before launching the new initiative, so he would actually kill it, block it, minimize exposure to it, and set up a procedure to handle the proposal through testing, no matter how much or how little the associated risk. The resulting chaos was confusing to the team, sending them into deep critter state. Now, the glaring gap in the consultant's training curriculum was in sales. So even though their role was heavily client-facing, the consultants weren't trained in the basic selling skills and had no incentive to do anything but fix technical problems. They also had no interaction with the sales team, who was sequestered in a different area of the building. So the consultants were the right people in the right role, but with no support to do their best. Harry, the new sales manager, had been with the firm for 3 months. Shortly after hiring Harry, the company had reorganized to close a failing business unit. Sarah and John had moved their niece, Tony, the VP of the failed unit, into a new role as the VP of sales and marketing. Wait a second. Did you hear that right? The niece was given one of the most important roles in the entire company after failing and killing an entire business unit. That sounds like a sacred cow to me. There were three problems with this scenario. Harry, who is now sales manager, had no sales expertise. His entire background was in internet marketing. Tony was an experienced sales manager, but wasn't strategic and had no marketing experience. The two disliked each other. Tony was threatened by Harry. Harry thought Tony should have been fired for her lackluster leadership of the failed business unit. So now, to make matters even more fun, Tony's boyfriend, Taylor, had been hired as director of client care. He had solid experience, but a perpetual mocking smirk on his face when he interacted with anybody outside of Tony. What did we do? Okay, this was a bit of a mess. First, we had John and Sarah create clear and compelling mission, vision, value statements so that everyone would understand why they were coming to work, where they were going together, how they agreed to behave. They posted these statements in the lobby. The managers worked with smaller teams until everyone was on board and living the mission, vision, values. Next, we established needle movers together, first for the executive team, later for everyone. And these are goals, if you will, KPIs, in line with the new mission, vision, values, and radically increased accountability using weekly reporting in the accountability equation. We created a recording process and a reporting process for the sales pipeline and marketing effectiveness metrics, and set up an incentive plan for the consultants to source future sales and be compensated for them. We also redefined the roles and responsibilities throughout sales and marketing because it was time to get the right people in the right roles. Some people were reallocated, one or two were let go respectfully. Since the company had a history of high turnover, it was key to minimize that critter state, that fight, flight, freeze, through thoughtful communication. So John, Sarah, Tony, Harry worked on their key challenges. Tony got the tools to turn her department around. Harry was moved out of sales management and into the right role, marketing, where he is brilliant and loves perpetually learning. He still reports to Tony, who now manages the sales team directly. Harry's initiatives had made really Company X top of mind in their target market. Now that John and Sarah communicate more explicitly without expecting people to magically figure out what they're talking about, they're no longer creating chaos. And Tony and Harry have developed mutual respect for each other. Taylor, the boyfriend, did have to be let go. He did not want to uphold the company values and had burned too many bridges. So what's the ROI? What did they get? After about 6 months into the coaching and change process, things got pretty scary. The consultants became resistant, didn't want to work on internal projects for which they had no billable hours, and John and Sarah almost pulled the plug and reverted to chaos. Instead, they worked on energy management, took the coaching, worked through their resistance, recommitted, held their team accountable to the direction they had chosen together. The results were not immediate. They rarely are with change work, but the patterns, as they occasionally resurfaced, were immediately addressed. Overall, the results have been phenomenal. They zoomed through to and through their 50 million revenue inflection point and are preparing for 100 million now. Their employee retention is now normal with their industry, and employee surveys show that engagement and satisfaction continue to improve. They did it. Yay for them. Thank you for joining me today. I want you to really start to think about, do you have the right people in the right roles, the right person in the wrong role, or just the wrong person to be a fit at your firm?
Thanks for joining me on this episode. Every listen, every share, every review helps others form their own smart tribes where teams are engaged, happy, and optimally performing. Together, you and I can help millions of people crack the behavior code in their organizations, families, and communities. I invite you to take 2 minutes and head over to smarttribesinstitute.com to discover more about how to form a smart tribe. See you there, and please tell your friends.